Hi folks, this is checkpoint quiz 10.3. We're given the angle theta equals negative 4 pi over 3. Our first task in part A is to sketch theta in standard position. Okay, so once again, to sketch an angle in standard position, what we do is we start with the vertex at the origin and the initial side along the positive x-axis. The negative here indicates we're rotating clockwise, and 4 pi over 3 is given in radian measure. So halfway around the circle is pi, which is 3 pi over 3. So I need to go halfway around the circle clockwise, and then an additional pi over 3. So that's theta is negative 4 pi over 3. In part B, we're asked to find two coterminal angles for theta other than theta itself, one positive and one negative. We can get the coterminal angles by adding and subtracting multiples of 2 pi. So theta plus 2 pi would be negative 4 pi over 3. Plus 2 pi would be 6 pi over 3, which is 2 pi over 3. And the other coterminal angle would be theta minus 2 pi, which would be negative 4 pi over 3 minus 6 pi over 3, which is negative 10 pi over 3. All right, in part C, we're asked to find the reference angle for theta, which is what we're going to call alpha. And, you know, we see geometrically that it's going to be pi over 3. But in general, when you have an angle in radian measure and you've got this fraction reduced to lowest terms, we see that we can get the reference angle quickly as pi over whatever that denominator is. So even if we didn't sketch it, we would know the reference angle is pi over 3. All right, in part D, we're asked to find the values of the six trigonometric functions of theta if they exist. Since theta is not a quadrantal angle, all six of them are going to exist. The only time we get in trouble is if we have a quadrantal angle, because in those cases, either the x or y coordinate is zero. But at this guy, we're going to get all of them. And we can use the fact that all the trig functions at negative 4 pi over 3 are going to be plus or minus all the trig functions at the reference angle, pi over 3. Since the terminal side of theta lies in quadrant 2, in quadrant 2, the x coordinate's negative and the y coordinate's positive. That means the cosine's negative, the sine's positive, and then we'll carry that all the way through. So if I want to get the cosine of theta, that's going to be negative cosine of pi over 3, because we're in quadrant 2, which is negative 1/2. And the sine of theta is going to be the same as the sine of pi over 3, because in quadrant 2, the y coordinate's positive, which is square root 3 over 2. All right, from the cosine, I can quickly get the secant of theta. The secant of theta is 1 over the cosine of theta. So I take the reciprocal of negative 1/2, and that gives me negative 2. The cosecant of theta, using the reciprocal identity, is 1 over sine theta. If I take the reciprocal of this, I get 2 over square root 3, which is normally rationalized to 2 square root 3 over 3. Now I get the tangent of theta. The tangent of theta, I can either take the sine of theta divided by the cosine of theta, or I can use reference angles. And since sine is positive and cosine is negative, the tangent of theta is negative tangent pi over 3, which is negative square root 3. Or I could just take the sine divided by the cosine and get that. And then the cotangent of theta is going to be similarly negative cotangent pi over 3. Or I could take the cosine divided by the sine and get negative square root 3 over 3. So that'll do it for number 1. All right, number 2, we're to suppose theta is a quadrant 4 angle with tangent of theta equals negative 1 half. And in part A, we're asked to find the values of the 5 remaining trigonometric functions of theta if they exist. So what do we know about theta? We know that when you graph theta in standard position, its terminal side lies in quadrant 4. That's it. We don't know if theta is a clockwise rotation or a counterclockwise rotation, or maybe it goes around 2 or 3 times. Who knows? We're just told that the tangent of theta is negative 1/2. Now, at this point, a common mistake is students will say, well, tangent is sine over cosine. So that means sine's got to be 1, cosine's got to be 2. That can't be. Cosine can never get bigger than 1. So at this case, I highly encourage you to just use identities to get, the secant, and then you'll see what the cosine really is. So that's the first task, is using identities, what can we get from this? So one way to go about it, as I mentioned, is use identities. If you go the identity route, we know that 1 plus the tangent squared of theta is the secant squared of theta. And so if I substitute in the negative 1/2, I'm going to get secant squared of theta is 1 plus a fourth, which is 5/4, which means that the secant of theta is plus or minus the square root of 5/4, which is plus or minus square root 5 over 2. Since theta is a quadrant 4 angle, the cosine here is positive, the secant here is positive because the x coordinates are positive. So that gives me that the secant of theta is the square root of 5 over 2. Now, once I get the secant of theta, I can quickly get to the cosine of theta using the reciprocal identities. I take the reciprocal of this, it's 2 over square root 5, which is 2 square root 5 over 5. Alright, so there I've picked up secant and cosine. So now what's left is sine, cosecant, and cotangent. Well, the next one that's quick to get is cotangent. Since the tangent isn't 0, I can get the cotangent by taking the reciprocal of the tangent. And so I take the reciprocal of negative 1/2, and I get that the cotangent is negative 2. So now we're down to finding the sine and the cosecant. Either of those will give me the other because they're reciprocals of each other. So at this case, we have several different ways we could approach it. We could use the identity that 1 plus cotangent squared is cosecant squared. Take square roots and get it that way. We could use that sine squared plus cosine squared is 1. Or we could go back to the identity I mentioned at the beginning here. I know that the tangent of theta is the sine of theta over the cosine of theta, which means that the sine of theta is the tangent of theta times the cosine of theta. And the tangent of theta is negative 1/2. And the cosine of theta is 2 square root 5 over 5. So we get negative square root 5 over 5. once we have the sine of theta, then I can quickly get the cosecant of theta, because that's just the reciprocal of the sine of theta. And that gives me the cosecant of theta. Well, let's see, if I take the reciprocal of this, that's negative 5 over square root 5, which reduces to negative square root 5. Okay, so that's one way to go about finding these values.